Hey, what's going on, you guys? It's your boy Tom back once again, and I guess you probably noticed me doing this video in my closet this time, with my $400 microphone in the background, which is a great quality of how I do my rap songs with my brother here and there. Yeah, but on this video, I just basically want to expose like the false doctrine of some Christians believing that all sins being equal when there's Bible proof that God said that some sins are worse than others, and I'll get in the scriptures pretty soon there too. Yeah, but I'll tell you one thing, like, even before I came to the kingdom of God and learned, like, all this truth about God's kingdom and his word, I never believed all sins were equal. Like, I always had it in me that, like, that other sins would be worse than others. And it just makes sense that way, that God would punish some people worse than others, like, depending how evil they were. You know, like, if you're more evil than other people, God will, like, punish you more and condemn you more. And plus, if all sins were equal, then hiding your sin would not be worse than sinning out in the open. And now time to go to scripture. So to prove that all sins are not equal, I'm going to go to the book of 1 John chapter 5, verse 16. We're 1 John chapter 5, verse 16, it says, "If you see a brother or sister sinning in a way that does not lead to death, you should pray and God will give that person life. But there is sin that leads to death, and I'm not saying you should pray for those who commit it." And verse 17, it says, "All wicked actions are sin, but not every sin leads to death." So basically, it's telling you right there. And now I'm going to read from the book of John chapter 19, verse 11, where it says, "Then Jesus said, 'You would have no power over me at all unless it were given to you from above. So the one who handed me over to you has the greater sin.'" Yeah, because I even heard this one person say that she thinks all sins are equal because the Bible says there's no greater sin. Well, in John 19, verse 11, just said, like, that talked about, like, the type of people who has the greater sin. Yeah, and plus, if all sins were equal, then there would not be a different levels in hell, where some people will get more punished than others, like, depending how evil they were. You know, as I'm going to go to the book of Ezekiel chapter 32, verses 22 through 32, where we'll talk about the different levels in hell. Yeah, and in this chapter, in these verses, it'll talk about Egypt falls into the pit. And the pit means hell. So I'll start at 22, where it says, "Assyria lies there surrounded by the graves of its army, those who were slaughtered by the sword. Their graves are in the depths of the pit, and they are surrounded by their allies. They struck terror in their hearts of people everywhere, but now they have been slaughtered by the sword. And Elam lies there surrounded by the graves of its hordes, those who were slaughtered by the sword. They struck terror in their hearts of people everywhere, but now they have descended as outcasts to the world below." And below, it's somewhere in hell, though. "Now they lie in the pit and share the shame of those who have gone before them. They have a resting place among the slaughters surrounded by the graves of all their hordes. Yes, they terrorize the nations while they live, but now they lie in shame with others in the pit," which pit means hell, "and all of them outcasts slaughtered by the sword." And verse 26, it says, "Meshech and Tubal are there surrounded by the graves of all their hordes. They once struck terror in the hearts of people everywhere, but now they are outcasts all slaughtered by the sword. They're not buried in honor like the fallen heroes who went down to the grave with their weapons, their shields covering their bodies and their swords beneath their heads. Their guilt rests upon them because they brought terror to everyone while they were all still alive." Like, this crap's crazy right here. And verse 28 says, "You too, Egypt, will lie crushed and broken among the outcasts, all slaughtered by the sword. Edom is there with its kings and princes. Mighty as they were, they also lie among those slaughtered by the sword, with the outcasts who have gone down into the pit." Like I said before, pit is hell. So, and verse 30 says, "All the princes of the north and the Shidonians are there with others who have died." It's crazy, man. Sounds terrible. And then, "Once a terror, they have been put to shame. They lie there as outcasts with others who were slaughtered by the sword. They share the same of all who had descended into the pit. When Pharaoh and his entire army arrive, he will take comfort that he is not alone in having his hordes killed, says the Sovereign Lord. Although I have caused this terror to fall upon the living, Pharaoh and his hordes will lie there among the outcasts who were slaughtered by the sword. I, the Sovereign Lord, has spoken. So yeah, God says it right there, and that's why it's always good to like to read the scriptures and dig deep into the scriptures for ourselves, like to see what God says, because I never believed all sins were equal, even when I was worldly before coming into his kingdom. Like, I hear like some of these Christians say, like, yeah, all sins are equal because sin is sin. Regarding if you killed someone or if you swore, when killing a person is much worse than swearing. Because even Revelation chapter 21, verse 8, it says, but cowards, unbelievers, the corrupt, murderers, the immoral, those who practice witchcraft, idol worshippers, and all liars, their fate is in the fiery lake of burning sulfur, which is the second death. And in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9 through 10, where 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9 through 10 says, don't you realize that those who do wrong will not inherit the kingdom of God? Don't fool yourselves. Those who indulge in sexual sin or worship idols or commit adultery or male prostitutes or practice homosexuality or are thieves or greedy people or drunkards or abusive or cheat people, none of these will inherit the kingdom of God. And God, where Jesus never said a person who cusses will not inherit the kingdom of God, because Peter was a cussing man. As it says in the book of Matthew, chapter 26, verse 74, but cussing still is a sin, though, even though, don't get me wrong, I know we all cuss, like, when we get frustrated or we mess up or forget something, like, don't get me wrong, like, a cuss word just slips out at times. So basically, it's clear that cussing is one of those sins that do not lead to death. And for anyone who says all sins are equal, now I'm going to read from the book of Ezekiel, chapter 16, verse 47 to 57, where it talks about judgment on Jerusalem's prostitution. And here's what God says about all this. But you have not merely sinned as you did. You quickly surpassed them in corruption. As surely as I live, says the Sovereign Lord, Sodom and her daughters were never as wicked as you and your daughters. Sodom's sins were pride, gluttony, and laziness, while the poor and needy suffered outside her door. She was proud and committed detestable sins, so I wiped her out, as you have seen. Even Samaria did not commit half your sins. You have done far more detestable things than your sisters ever did. They seem righteous compared to you. Shame on you. Your sins are so terrible that you make your sisters seem righteous, even virtuous. But someday I will restore the fortunes of Sodom and Samaria, and I will restore you too. Then you will be truly ashamed of everything you have done, for your sins make them feel good in comparison. Yes, your sisters Sodom and Samaria and all their people will be restored, and at that time you will be restored. In your proud days you held Sodom in contempt, but now your greater wickedness has been exposed to all the world. And you are the one who is scorned by Edom and all our neighbors by Philistia. Yep, so God says it right there again, that he said, like, those people's sins were greater than the others. And also, to prove how all sins are not equal, God says, like, some sins are an abomination compared to others, like homosexuality. I don't blame God for saying that's an abomination, because God created man for woman, and not man for man, and woman for woman. And you also got the seven deadly sins that especially lead to death, but like sins like swearing does not lead to death. That's just easy to tell. But now I'm going to read from the book of Matthew, chapter 12, verse 31, where like any of you will feel good when you hear about this scripture, because I learned about this last year, and Matthew chapter 12, verse 31, it says, so I tell you, every sin and blasphemy can be forgiven, except blasphemy against the Holy Spirit, which will never be forgiven. I first read that last year, it did scare me, like, hoping I never did it. And there's even some people out there that feel that they've done too much wrong, where they feel like God will not forgive them, when it's not true, when that scripture says God can forgive any sin or blasphemy, except for blasphemy against the Holy Spirit. And just like God will never forgive you if you take the mark of the beast as well. So you stay away from that as well. And that's why it's always good to dig into the scriptures yourself to see what God has to say. Because I have been deceived by, like, some Christians out there on what they believe. But even if you show some Christian scripture proof on something, like, some of them will refuse to believe it, when there's no need to be ignorant debaters, when God's word will always remain the same truth on what you research. And God will prove everyone wrong when they die as their soul comes out their body to meet God, and on Judgment Day anyway. But before I shut this video down, I just want to give a shout out to my big sister in Christ named Crystal out there. So I just want to say I thank God for you, Crystal, because you're like a real blessing girl who's special to God, and I love you, and it's great where we're connected in such a good way where we have a lot of things in common. So keep up the awesome personality you got, and I hope you continue to obey God more and really please Him. So much love from your boy. Much love from your homie Tom, and that's all for this video, and you guys take care in Jesus' name. So, amen.
It's funny how money changes situation. Miscommunication lead to complication. My emancipation don't fit your equation. I was on the humble, you on every station. Someone play young Lauren like she done. But remember not to game the one of the sun. Everything you did has already been done. I know all the tricks from bricks to Kingston. My ting done, major kingdom, one run. Now understand El Boogie, not violent. But if a thing test me, run for me gun. Can't take a threat to me newborn son. El been this way since creation. A groupie call you far from temptation. Now you on ball over separation. Tarnish my image in the conversation. Who you gon' scrimmage like you the champion? You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. Now, how come your talk turned cold? Gain the whole world for the price of your soul. Trying to grab hold of what you can't control. Now you all lost for the sight to behold. Wisdom is better than silver and gold. I was hopeless, now I'm on hope roll. Every man wanna act like he's exempt. Need to get down on his knees and repent. Can't slick talk on the day of judgment. The movement's similar to a serpent. Try to play straight, how your whole style been? Consequences, no coincidence. Hypocrites always wanna play innocent. Always wanna take it to the full out extent. Always wanna make it seem like good intent. Never wanna face it when it's time for punishment. I know you don't wanna hear my opinion. There's how many paths and you must choose one. And if you don't change, then the rain soon comes. See, you might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just won one. You might win some, but you just lost one.
You might win some, but you really
the bar.